You are now tuning into Vibes. Oh, so now y'all want to be woke when a bitch been in an alarm clock since day one. Well, beep, beep, motherfuckers. Beep, beep. Welcome to the show. If y'all don't know what that's from, then you're not my friend and you can't hang with me. You guys, welcome back to another episode of Vibes. And, y'all, we got some things to talk about. We got some things to get off of our chest because we're in this together. We're all in this together. Everyone clap your hands, make a dream come true. I don't know if those are the right words. Fuck you. You guys, it's me, and again, this is another episode of Vibes, and before I continue to lose my shits, let's get into the song of the week. This is, I like this song. You know, I felt like we needed to be a little trap, you know, like trap with her trapping ass, so I was in a trap mood, so let's get into the song of the week. This is... And yes, this is her name, Lightskinkeisha. Judge her if you must be judging. Lightskinkeisha with Treadmill. You guys get into the song of the week and I will be right back.
Young nigga made move like Treadmill. Run it up like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Money dance on the Treadmill. Do a stance on the Treadmill. Can't stop on the Treadmill. Money don't stop on the Treadmill. Young nigga made move like Treadmill. Run it up like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Money dance on the Treadmill. Do a stance on the Treadmill. Can't stop on the Treadmill. Money don't stop on the Treadmill. Put me on your damn plate. I let him get a taste. Taste sweet jet like cake. Stick it in the damn shake. Might cause an earthquake. Fly like out of space. Big booty and small waist. Big booty girl named Judy. Soft ass lips real juicy. That's why your boyfriend choosing. Little bitch, I'm winning, you losing. Little bitch is running around clueless. Nigga say, oh my goodness. His mind, I'ma make him lose it. Hair done, nails done, yeah, real cute. Yeah, he's on my to-do list. Got the nigga acting real foolish. Only new hundreds, all blue shit. Call this bitch no flu shit. If you ain't know, I'm on some new shit. I'm a nice girl, but don't push it. Been winning, but they been nudist. If not me, then I'm like, new man, move like Treadmill. Run it up like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Money dance on the Treadmill. Do a stance on the Treadmill. Can't stop on the Treadmill. Money don't stop on the Treadmill. Young nigga make move like Treadmill. Run it up like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Money dance on the Treadmill. Do a stance on the Treadmill. Can't stop on the Treadmill. Money don't stop on the Treadmill. Every day I celebrate. Like it my birthday. Queenie like Beyonce. From the east, I'm a name day. Top flight like Day Day. And them folks like Michi. Wild thoughts like Riri. Stack it up like Big Meat. First class when I take a flight. He like my jeans cause they fit me tight. Don't play with me, nigga, I'll change your life. As soon as I see him, it's on sight. I plan to ride him like he a bike. He wanna beat it, put up a fight. My shit is fire like candlelight. The freak in me only come out at night. One check, two check. Verify, blue check. Foot on, they neck. This wave, they gon' catch. I'm fucking this shit up and that's a fact. Getting this money, keep me a rack. These bitches gon' hate, I'ma keep them mad. They look up to me, they don't know me. Move like Treadmill. Run it up like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Money dance on the Treadmill. Do a stance on the Treadmill. Can't stop on the Treadmill. Money don't stop on the Treadmill. Young nigga make move like Treadmill. Run it up like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Flex all like Treadmill. Money dance on the Treadmill. Do a stance on the Treadmill. Can't stop on the Treadmill. Money don't stop on the Treadmill.
Yeah, I'm back. Y'all, that was, I like that joint. It's a trap joint, you know, in my mind. Fuck it up on a treadmill. Y'all, that was Lightskinkeisha. That's her name. That's her artist name. Don't judge me. Motherfucker, that's her name. That's the name she chose. Lightskinkeisha. M-S-K-E-I-S-H-A. Y'all can spell light skin. Not L-I-T-E with your dumb asses. Oh, Jesus Christ. Light. Like a light that you turn on and off. Like the appropriate use of the word light when you're referring to someone's skin complexion. L-I-G-H-T. Jesus Christ. If you can't spell, I'm not helping y'all out with the rest of this. Lightskinkeisha. Download that song. It's on SoundCloud right now. And then you all can follow her on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Lightskinkeisha. All that. One word. Everything is together. You guys, let's get into some black shit. Girl, what's all this black shit? I don't know. Black ass shit. Now, this first story is the blackest shit that blackest shit can be. So, there was this AT&T worker was fired after he cash-apped himself $50 from the customer's phone. Now, if this ain't some hood nigga shit, then I don't know what is. So, the AT&T tech worker was in this woman's home hooking up her internet. And he says, ma'am, can I see your phone so I can check to see if the internet is working? Scam. I mean, that's a scam because all you need, if you got an AT&T box, if the light turned green and the shit is working. The lady gave him her phone. And then, you know, in the midst of pretending to see if the internet was working, he goes into her fucking cash app and then sends himself $50. And then he gives the lady back her phone. You know, before he left, the lady notices that he sent $50 fucking dollars from her account. Now she asked him about it and he lied, of course, because niggas lie. Niggas lie, niggas lie, niggas lie, men lie. Niggas and men, two different things. And then she kept asking him soon, you know, he admitted and was like, what can I do to fix this? And she was like, you could talk to my husband because that's his money. And then that nigga got scared. Let me tell y'all something. Like, first off, you're an AT&T tech worker. Now, you can't be out here struggling for $50 unless you just on crack or some shit. Like, you got to be out here bad if you stealing $50, like $50. Now, if I'm just going to, you know, if I'm going to be stealing from people, cash apping myself money from somebody else's phone, which is not going to be $50, it's going to be $500 or $5,000. I'm not going to be $50. Let me send myself $50 just to see if it works. No, bitch, let me send myself $500 just to see if it's real. First off, you don't even know how to steal right. You don't even know how to do wire fraud right. You, anywho, you, as an AT&T worker, you can't be struggling that bad, sir. Because they make good money. They make decent money. I gotta start watching Tyler Perry. but you legit, you can't be struggling that bad if you are stealing $50 from the customers. Like, shout out to my AT&T man who came here. He ain't steal from me, y'all. Because I finally got my own internet and I stopped stealing from my mama. Whew. Oh my God, y'all, the adult life. But shout out to my AT&T man who came here and was here legit for like 2 hours, primarily because he was trying to get my number, and he ended up giving me his. But anywho, he stayed here 2 hours to fix the problem because I got my box and it wasn't working. And he told me that the other dude came out. I didn't even know his ass was here. He didn't ring my doorbell. And he didn't do anything he was supposed to do. He literally drove by just to say that he was here and then put in some false notes. So, I mean, AT&T, y'all got to stop this shit. And now you got people stealing $50, like cash apping. Let me see if the internet working now. Nigga, that's what the machine is for. That's what that big ass calculator looking thing is for that you got in your hand. Why you need her phone for? Let me see if the internet working. Scamming ass niggas. Y'all, please get y'all cousins and y'all brothers and y'all uncles and your daddies, because your daddy's doing it too. They out here stealing $50 from women who need more. Speaking of stealing, I mean, this is has nothing to do with stealing. But I really want y'all to help y'all cousin, because we're moving on to the next story. Y'all cousin Columbus Short is still out here struggling. Now, an arrest warrant has been issued for Columbus Short for failure to appear in court. And this is relating to his divorce with his ex-wife. I don't even think they're officially divorced yet. I don't know her name. It's like Shay or something. Shay Short. Might be wrong. Not really sure. But he failed to appear in court, and that was part of his probationary hearing in the divorce proceedings. Now, this recent picture of Columbus, he just looks coked out, y'all. Somebody help the man. Now, that's not lies right there. Those are facts. He admitted to doing cocaine. Like, he actively still uses the shit. I want somebody to help me understand how, and I get it, I understand drugs and how they take effect on you, and I got all of that, okay? You know, I work in the industry, not in the industry, but I work with people who abuse drugs, so I know that. But somebody, you have to help me understand, how do you choose drugs over making $150,000 an episode? Like, that's why his ass got fired from Scandal. Because you chose drugs. You didn't even know how to not use drugs at work. Like, nigga, if you just gonna have a drug habit, do that shit outside of work. Like, find a level. Find a fucking cutoff point. Like, can't fuck up my money, because I'm gonna need this money in order to continue with my drug habit. So let me figure out, what's that line I can't cross? Because, y'all, he out here struggling. He looks terrible, too. And he is going through the motions. He must have been high. Because you just out here missing court dates. I think that's a Hollywood thing, though. I don't think anybody in Hollywood goes to court anymore. They just refuse to show up. Because they'll have their lawyer go and do some magic spell shit and be like, that was almost a good segue for another story, but we'll keep that. But the lawyers go in there and they do some hocus pocus shit and be like, you know what, you don't even have to go to court. Actually, your entire criminal record has been expunged. You're not a criminal anymore. And I'd be like, what the fuck? Is this what money pays for? I need some of it. I don't have a criminal record, so that doesn't apply to me. But I am a thug. I have a thug record. Speaking of thugs, let's move on to your uncle, nephew, Bow Wow. I don't even understand why I'm talking about him. But I mean, I guess he was in the news. So y'all remember when Bow Wow made that long ass Instagram post that was like 6 pages and 7 years long about how he had a lean addiction and he used to, you know, drink lean every day. And, you know, Omarion noticed that, you know, he was fucked up, but he couldn't kick the habit. Right. You remember that? Barely. Okay, it's cool. So y'all know his daddy, I don't know what to call his big brother JD, was on, he went on the Breakfast Club and was basically like, that shit wasn't real. He had no fucking lean addiction. He's making it up. Now, here's the thing, you guys. I feel like Bow Wow has been making up a lot of stuff for Instagram. Like, he's going through some shit over there. And this is still a cry for help. Like, I feel like, because the attention is not on him anymore, like, at all, we don't want to hear anything from him. Because, you know, I feel like since the attention is not on him at all, like, that's what he's struggling with. He's struggling with not being in the spotlight, with no one really, how can I put this? He's struggling with people not really giving a fuck about him anymore, for lack of a better, you know, phrase. I mean, here's the thing. I used to be a huge Bow Wow fan when I was 13, up until I was like 15, 16. Like, you couldn't tell me anything about Bow Wow. And then I traded him out for Chris Brown. But then Chris, my choice in men is questionable. But I used to be a huge Bow Wow fan, right? Right. Okay, great. And then I moved on. And now, you honestly can't really pay me to listen to some new Bow Wow music, because I can't take him serious anymore. Because now he's like an adult child, because we always look at him as a child, even though that's not fair to him because he's a grown ass man right now. But it's like, we only see you as, you know, little Bow Wow. You just don't know the way you move so fast across the floor. I mean, you run through my mind like, I remember that song. That's my jam. But we don't see him as an adult. And now you try to make new music and you're talking about, you know, busting hoes wide open and popping pills and drinking lean, and you got shooters. I can't take you seriously, because who's going to be at your beck and call when you call some people, be like, I need some shooters? Who is this? It's Bow Wow. Nigga, get off my phone. Like, no, I can't take you serious. So I can't take him serious when he's talking about he had a lean addiction. Like, you, I mean, if you have a lean addiction, it's obvious, because you look like you have a lean addiction. Like, we could look at Future and tell that nigga drinks cough syrup every day, all day. We could look at Lil Wayne and tell. It's obvious. I mean, you don't even have to look at his face. You could just look at his body and be like, yeah, he's on lean. Bad. You can look at Designer. You don't have to look at him. You can listen to him. And you'll be like, yeah, he's on more than lean. And he's on a lot of lean and more lean and a little bit of crack inside the lean also. Like, you can just, you listen to Designer's music and you'll be like, yeah. Because, I mean, at this point, it's obvious. Like, certain rappers, you can just look at and be like, yeah, you are a crackhead, and it's obvious. But when Bow Wow's out here talking about, I used to pop pills, I used to have this lean addiction, you know, I got shooters, niggas don't believe me, keep fucking with me, I got shooters up top. And it's like, sir, you live in a really pretty condo, you can't possibly have shooters. I don't understand. Like, I can't take the things that he says serious. Like, I can't. And I know that's a problem, again, because he's a grown-ass man. So he's going to have to do something, I don't want to say dramatic, but he's going to have to change his whole, what do you call it? He's going to have to change his image. Because I think maybe that's the thing. He hasn't really gone through like an image change where he can still be himself. You know how artists, like, if we've known them for a really long time, they've been in the rap industry or just in the music industry for 10, 15 years, like, they go through these phases where they change their image so that we'll still be attracted to their music and want to support them. I feel like Bow Wow has never gone through that. He's never changed his image. And not to say that, you know, you need to change your image, but I feel like he's never changed his image into like an adult image. Like, I'm grown now, look at me. That's why people still look at him as a kid. And that's why we're not going to take him fucking serious at all. Like, in any way, shape, or form. And speaking of shapes and forms, Beyonce. Because she got a shape and a form. Hey, girl! But that's not what we're talking about. So, now, I don't know how true this story is. I'm just reporting it. So, Beyonce's former drummer, I don't know her name because her name is not important. So, again, former drummer Beyonce said that she's accusing. This story is so fucking ridiculous. This girl said Beyonce killed her cat and then she used magic spells to molest her. So, let's break this down. So, number one, Beyonce killed her cat. Why the fuck you bringing a cat to dance rehearsal? It's not a dog. It's a fucking cat. Wait, why? Why? You know what? I'm not saying that Beyonce killed the cat, but if I was Beyonce, I'm not an animal killer. And a cat was in my fucking way. Because there should not be a cat at my fucking dance rehearsal. And if I accidentally stepped on your fucking cat and it died. This story is absurd. Now, Beyonce killed her cat. How? How did Beyonce kill your cat? Okay, let's skip that. Let's go to this part where She accused Beyonce of using magic spells to molest her. What the fuck? What were the magic spells? What did they sound like? Jolly, that, wait, smack it in the air. Hocus, pocus, slap, wait, smack it in the air. Hocus, wait, oh, hey, that's in the air. Clap, clap. Was that the, I don't understand. How the fuck does somebody use magic spells to molest you? Like, oh, maybe y'all won't come after me because, you know, Beyonce didn't do any of this. But I just had a theory in my head, but I'm not going to say it out loud because now it sounds really stupid that I'm thinking about it. I can't go on with this story because it's so fucking stupid. Beyonce killed your cat and then she used magic spells to molest you. Now, I'm not making fun of molestation. But girl, I think she's one of them like crazy ass stans who thinks that, you know, Beyonce is there with her at every minute of the day. Like, I think she believes she lives with Beyonce. Somebody need to find her and get her some help. But I really want to know, what's the story? Like, what did she make up on how Beyonce killed her cat? And you guys, when I first read this story, I really laughed from a very, very unhealthy place. Because, you know, animal cruelty is not funny. But that was funny to me. Like, she, and the story, the headline actually went, Beyonce killed her kitten. That's not funny. And I refuse to go to hell. Jesus. Beyonce, nope, I won't do it. I won't do it. You guys, that's it for black shit. Let's move on to what the fuck, Chicago. It's Mimi Wallace reporting live from the funeral of the cat that Beyonce killed. Here are your weekly updates for What the Fuck, Chicago. A woman was fatally struck by a car early Sunday morning in the suburb of Mundelein. Witnesses have said that the woman thought that because she was white, she could use her magical powers of, "You're not going to touch me." She was wrong. She died. Jason Van Dyke, who is the police officer accused of killing Laquan McDonald, legal team stated that only one of the 16 shots mattered. Right. Because the other 15 were just practice, so they didn't count towards, like, you know, his death. 47 dogs have died at a PetSmart in the past 10 years after being groomed. And by groomed, they mean sexually assaulted. Because how else are the pets going to die? These are your weekly updates for What the Fuck, Chicago. Jesus. I feel like I'm going to hell. And by hell, I mean that very dark, hot place. I feel like I'm going in, you know, just a little bit. You guys, let's get into the question of the week. And is y'all ready or is y'all not? Let's get into it. Question of the week. All right, you guys. So this week, I wanted to know, like, what were people willing to do, or what would you be willing to do to continue a relationship with your spouse? Some of y'all crazy, and you know, all of y'all can't be trusted. So, the question of the week is, do you still support your spouse after you find out they've done something terrible? Now, not like a, oh my God, my husband or wife spent all of our money in the joint saving. I mean, that's terrible, but I'm talking about terrible, I kill somebody, sexual assault, you know, terrible shit. So I know the question was super vague, but thanks to the people who responded who helped me out. So, posted that question. I'll read some of the comments. So, shout out to podcast spoilers. They said, like, they bought milk past the expiration date horrible, or they've been strangling prostitutes in the basement horrible. Thank you, sir, for that. That really helped me out. And my response was strangling prostitutes, bestiality, fraud, money laundering, sexual assault, like terrible shit. Let's see. I still don't understand the comment, but Gordon Publishing said without them knowing. I don't, so does that mean you're still going to support them? Oh, you'll support them without them knowing. I don't understand how you do that. Because they'll know that you're fucking supporting them. Let's see who else we have. We have the Let's Chat podcast said, based on these things, I'm going to go with a whole entire no. Money laundering isn't as terrible as the others. He can pay those back in due time. Okay. Be barred from handling funds, etc. But those others, I cannot sleep next to him again. And bestiality, bruh, could never touch me again. All right, so let's kind of get into that. With the money laundering, that's not as terrible as everything else. Like, he could pay those back and he'd just be barred from handling funds. I mean, I guess that's a good thing. You're very forgiving. That's good for you. Let's see. Mark LaVar said, depends. You people and your really established answers. 38 Flavors said, hell nah, sis. Won't judge anything, but I will distance myself though. Here's my thing, my take on this. Thanks to everyone who responded and who answered the question. I'm pretty sure there are some other ones, but that's on the other apps and I'm not switching. So here's my thing, or here's my take. If I'm in a relationship and I found out that you've done something extremely terrible, like the stuff that I've named, then the relationship is over, honestly. Because at that point, if you've done something like that, that means that you made a decision. You made a conscious effort to make that decision and make that choice because you thought that was going to be the shortcut. I can't, you know, if you out here, you know, committing acts of bestiality and you're money laundering and you're strangling prostitutes. No, I can't. The answer is no. But what I will do is I will continue to support you as a friend. And I'm not going to sit and tell you that, you know what? I'm not going to like baby anything or sugarcoat anything. I'm going to give it to you straight up and let you know what you did was wrong. I'll support you as a friend, but if we're in a relationship, that shit is over. Cause don't nobody got time for that shit. That's going to be a no for me, dog. Again, thanks everybody who responded to the question of the week. We're going to move on to the topic of the week, which goes again in hand with the question of the week. This week's topic is supporting or nah. I didn't give this a title, as you could definitely tell. My God, I'm sorry, I just drew a blank. You know how you draw blanks and then you just forget like 100%? What the fuck you were talking about? That just happened to me. Again, this week's topic of the week basically is to support or to not support. And it goes hand in hand with the question of the week. So, first point, when we're talking about to support or not to support is, I just kind of went over this, but do you still support your spouse after you find out? So, what's next? Now, we all have our different versions of, you know, after we found out. A lot of people make up stories and they'll be like, Oh, girl, especially with women. Oh, girl, after I found out, I kicked his ass to the curb, and I threw all his stuff out, and then I told his mama, don't call me no more because we not together, and then the whole time, you know, he's still in the house. And y'all might not just be talking to each other, but he still lives there. Or she still lives there. I think dudes do this too. Bruh, nah, I kicked that ass out. She ain't shit. Y'all don't need to fuck with her like that no more. And the whole time, she still lives there. So it's like, okay, a lot of us lie about things like this. If you're going to support the person, then support the person. Don't be ashamed. But the thing is, what's that step, or what does it look like after you find out? So let's see, what's something that's really, really terrible? I mean, cheating, it's so sad to say this, but cheating right now is basic. That sounds terrible. Because it's not a lot of faithful people out here. It's not a lot of monogamous people out here. But cheating is basic. So let's say this. So you just found out. It could be, you know, vice versa, either or, man or woman. So you just found out that your spouse, man, what's some terrible, terrible shit? How about this? You just found out that your spouse was sleeping with your best friend, and they were plotting, and they've been stealing money from you the entire time. How about, I mean, if that's not terrible, I don't know. You know, I'm not really a terrible person. So let's go with that. Your spouse has been sleeping with your best friend, and not your, like, your best friend of like 2-3 years. No. This is your childhood best friend. Y'all know everything about each other, okay? At this point, this person is your sibling. Found out your spouse has been sleeping with your best friend, and the entire time, they've been sleeping together for years, but also they've been stealing money from you for years. So the whole time, you've been thinking that you're losing money or you're spending too much, but the whole time you find out your spouse and your best friend have been stealing money from you. Okay, the whole time. That's some terrible shit. You find this out, and do you still support your spouse? Do you still support your best friend? How do you handle that? What's that after situation looking like? Because you know what? It's easy to say, hell nah, man, fuck them, and all of this stuff, and all of the bad stuff. It's easy to say that. But if this is your best friend since childhood, I don't think, honestly, it's going to be that easy to cut that relationship off. If you're talking about your spouse and this is a person that you love, it could be your girlfriend, boyfriend, husband, or wife, whatever. I don't think it's going to be that easy to just cut that relationship off. Or, you know, it doesn't have to be that situation, but this is just the one I'm going with. That's some terrible shit. For me, if I find out that my boyfriend has been sleeping with my best friend, and the entire time they've been stealing money from me, honestly, we're all going to sit together and we're going to talk, because that's the person I am. I really want to know why people do the things that they do. Like, sometimes I have to sit with myself and ask myself, why the fuck did you just do that? Like, what sense did that make to you? Because sometimes I'm baffled by the decisions that I make. So I want to know why I do some of the things I do. So I would really want to know, why did you all do this? Like, and it wouldn't be about me. What did I do to deserve this? And maybe, you know what? No, that's just the type of person I am. So we would sit and have a conversation, and we're going to get to the root of the problem. And we're going to figure out why they chose to do that and, you know, what led them to it. And if you've been sleeping, with each other behind my back the whole time, then you must really like each other. I'm going to assume that. Because if you've had to sneak and do this and you've made the decision, because at this point, if you continue to make the same mistake, you know, more than twice, it's not a mistake anymore. It's a decision, right? Okay, boom. So at this point, I'm going to assume that this is the decision that you all have made. So I'm going to think that the deciding factor is that you all want to be together. Because if that's something that you all did and you did it without hesitation and you did not factor into my feelings, then I'm going to assume that my feelings never mattered. So then you all can have each other. I don't know. I just don't get, I'm not going to get angry and mad and want to break shit and want to fight and do all of this stuff because that's too much of my energy going into a negative situation. And I just don't want that. And speaking like about negative situations, I always see this as a negative situation. And we're moving on to the next point. So you find these things out. And you know that social media plays a huge part in people's relationships nowadays. It just does. That's why people have all these damn goals. Relationship goals. Bae goals. Wifey goals. Husband goals. Shut the fuck up. Your goals are simple. So the point is, all right, you find out your best friend has been sleeping with your spouse and they've been stealing money from you the whole time. So you're trying to figure out why your savings, you know, keep... while your funds and your savings are disappearing, you thinking it's your spouse just, you know, going out shopping and spending too much fucking money. No, they've been stealing it from you the whole time. Okay, bam. So you don't know. You're on the fence about support. Maybe you have still decided to support them. The next kind of question is, or point is, do you support them via social media? Because that's super important. If you're not supporting someone, and it's just crazy to say that, if you're not supporting someone via social media and you're in a relationship, then, you know, everybody's questioning you as to whether that relationship is real. You know, if you don't support me on social media, then you don't support me at all because the people need to know. So, you know, it could be obvious. Like, let's say, you know, you find this stuff out, you choose not to support them. Do you go on social media? Do you blast them? Or do you say, you know, at this time, you know, we're taking a break, whatever. How about this? Do you publicize it on social media? Whether you chose to or not to support your spouse. Because I'm going to go with the latter is you chose not to support that person or your spouse. And then then you decided to go on social media and let the whole world know about your business or their business or you all's business. So do you support social media? I'm going to say no. I'm not like a get on social media and, you know, tell my whole personal relationship. That's not me. It has never been me. So some of y'all probably won't ever know that I'm in a fucking relationship. I'm currently not. I'm very single. Holla at me. A bitch is single. But no, for real, y'all. I'm not that person to get on social media and then share my entire life. Like, if you want to know something, then ask me. And I don't have a problem with telling you or letting you know. But if I find these things out and, you know, my best friend did this to me and I find out about the situation, I'm not going to social media to share this. Because there are too many unsolicited, unwanted opinions that are going to be coming back at me. And then I'm going to be distracted from the situation because I'm going to be solely focused on social media now. Now I'm going to be focused on trying to block people and their unwanted opinions. That's why the fuck you go to therapy. And here's the big thing for me. We always kind of run around the problem, but we never address it. So the next point is, do you directly address the thing, the problem, the issue? So when you talk about, like, let's say, you know, cheating, because it's very basic and a lot of people cheat, right? So you found out that your spouse, your boyfriend, girlfriend has cheated on you, right? Do you ever directly address it? And maybe this is just me and I just don't know. But I feel like a lot of people don't directly address the issue. They don't really talk about the thing because it'll be like, oh, I went through your phone. I know you cheating on me. I know you slept with that nigga. I know you slept with that hoe. I know y'all fucking. I know it because I seen it. But it's never, that's not addressing it though. Because first off, nobody's about to tell the truth. And so my thing would be, you have to address the thing like, okay, I'm going to ask you if you're cheating on me. I'm only asking you although I already know the answer because I have proof. What I want to know is, why did you decide to do that? Like, address the issue. Try to figure out what's wrong in the relationship that led to that. Because this is just me. I honestly don't think people just cheat just to cheat. I mean, there's some fucked up people out here, and that is what they do. They just like the attention. But I think for a lot of people who claim that, well, I love him and I love her and I didn't really want to do it, so we got to figure out what's that underlying issue. And that's what I mean by, do you directly address the thing, the problem, the issue? Because if your best friend is sleeping with your spouse and they're stealing from you, then and you've never said anything to them, the only thing is, oh, you've just found out. So now it's just like, you know, I'm going to fall back. I don't fuck with y'all no more. I wish the worst on y'all. You never addressed the problem now. So now it's going to be this awkwardness for the rest of forever. And you never addressed it. And it could have been something as simple as, I didn't like when you treated me like this. I didn't like when you did this to me and you never apologized. So it's like, address the thing. The big point for me is, or the kind of last and final point is, do you stay in the relationship? And what does it look like? It's okay. You know, if you find out that situation happened to you, your best friend out here sleeping with your spouse, your best friend out here sleeping with your boyfriend, with your girlfriend, your wife, your husband, they've been stealing money from you. Okay, you find all this stuff out. You decide to forgive them, but do you stay in a relationship? Just because you decide to forgive someone, that doesn't mean that you need to, or that doesn't mean that you've chosen to stay in that relationship. Because it could have been, I forgive you because of, I don't know, whatever reason you decided to forgive them, you know. But this here's why I chose to forgive you. I do value this and that, and I think you're a good person. Do you stay in a relationship? And what does that look like? Like, for me, if I find this stuff out, I can't stay in that relationship. Because now, I know that, like I said before, you made a conscious decision to hurt me. Because my feelings could not have been considered. We will sit and we will have this talk. But there is no way in that whole situation that you ever considered me once, right? So I cannot stay in this relationship with you because of your inconsiderate ways. Like, at this point, you're inconsiderate of my feelings. But I think for me, I would probably, honestly, if I found that out, I don't think I would be able to continue a friendship. I definitely forgive them. Just for the sake of, I don't like to go around harvesting these feelings of just, I don't know. I don't like to harvest my feelings of, you know, anger and sadness and all that stuff anymore. So I would have to get that out. So I would definitely, you know, if I found out about this situation, I would definitely forgive. But I don't know if I could continue on with a friendship or in a relationship if I found this information out. Because, again, you could not have considered my feelings. And you guys, you don't have to feel bad about it, because you can forgive someone and just choose not to have them in your space. You can forgive them and keep them afar. Like, I forgive you, all is well, but I don't need you in my space. I don't want your energy. I don't like your energy, but I wish you well. I truly do. And I think that would be me, because I'm not going to be able to look at you differently, even though you might have been a different person and you, that might have been years ago, you know, that this happened and you've changed and you've truly apologized and you've done everything that you can. I don't know that I'm going to be able to look at you differently. And it's not in I feel like you're going to do this again way. Every time I'm around you, I'm paranoid. It's just going to be, for me, I think it kind of goes back to this. It's different if you're not in your right state of mind. But most of us are. So we know the decisions we're making when we make them. So for me, it would be you were in your right state of mind and you still chose to do that and you thought it was okay. So from that point, I don't need you in my space. That would be me. But I don't know, you guys, this is something that I really want to know. Do you choose to stay in a relationship? Okay, so we just kind of recap. You find out, and this is just a situation I made up. I'm pretty sure some people out there did far worse or know far worse stories about things, terrible things that happen in a relationship. All right, so the scenario is you found out that your best friend has been sleeping with your spouse and they've been stealing money from you the entire time they've been sleeping together, right? They've literally been stealing money out of your savings account. This is money that you've been saving. Ooh, new scenario. This is the money you've been saving to buy you and your spouse a house, bars. The money you've been saving to buy a house for the two of you, right? As a surprise. But your spouse and your best friend been stealing that shit from you. And y'all how they gonna just be stealing? Your spouse has access to your accounts, right? So you're we're saving together. I guess that's what people do. You all, especially if you're in a marriage, you give each other access to the accounts, right? You share accounts and all of this stuff. So it's we don't hide anything from each other. That's a real relationship. However, you chose not to hide. Now your spouse has been secretly, funding her or his other relationship with your best friend. That's some terrible shit. Right? That's the scenario. So, do you still support your spouse after you find out about this whole relationship and they're stealing money? Do you take your spouse back, right? Do you forgive them? All right. Do you support them via social media? Because nowadays, social media is implemented into our relationships, our everyday relationships. And the fact that people rely so much on social media as a platform for the basis of their relationships, it's crazy. But that's how people see it. And it's not really real. I can't believe it. It's not factual until you notice me on social media. That's crazy. But whatever. Do you support your spouse via social media? All right. So we got that. Whatever your choice is. Next thing is, do you directly address the thing? Not go around the issue I know you've been cheating on me. The end. No. Address the issue, meaning, I know you've been cheating on me. I want to know why. Where in the relationship did we disconnect? And what were you feeling or how were you feeling when you made this decision? Why did we not talk about it? What was the miscommunication between the both of us? Address the thing, right? Okay, and then last point was, do you stay in the relationship? And what does that look like afterwards? I'm pretty sure some people out here who've done terrible shit to each other, probably the same thing in this scenario, and they are still in the relationship. I want to know what that looks like now, what your relationship is like now. If y'all know some people out here and they have something similar happen to them in their relationship and they're still together, can y'all have them email me at askvibez@gmail.com. That's askvibez@gmail.com, because I want to know what the story is. And you guys, that's it for question of the week. I just really wanted to talk about that because it's something that's very interesting to me. Because people out here, they're doing it and they're still in it and they think that it's okay. And I'm not judging, but I'm always curious to know what was your decision behind that to stay or to not stay, especially, in situations like that. So, you guys, let's move on to Ratchet Drink Chronicles. I must say, this drink that I made, it is actually delicious. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Praise God. All right, you guys, I'm drinking on a Reposado tequila. I don't know where you can get it from, but go find it. Reposado, that's R-E-S-P-A-D-O. P-A-S-A-D-O. I need to learn how to spell. So I'm drinking on Reposado tequila, a little sweet and sour mix, some, what's it called? Some sugar cane. No, that's not what it's called. Jesus Christ. Simple syrup. My God, am I simple. So, Reposado tequila, sweet and sour mix, simple syrup, and I have a mixed berry simply lemonade. This shit is delicious. It really is. You know, if you want to try like a different recipe with your tequila, mix it up. I'll save that for later. But that's what I'm drinking on, you guys. It's very good. Remember, again, a lady never takes a sips. She takes a squig. Hold on, bitches, while I squig. Praise God. Praise God for squigs. You guys, let's move on to shout-outs of the motherfucker world. My God. So my first shout out goes out to my Soros, my ships. Shout out to my Soros, Bertina, Tracy, Rhonda, Gertha. We went out to celebrate. We're a little late, but we went out to celebrate Gertha's birthday. And I was just as surprised. I didn't know where the fuck we were going. But shout out to B. She planned everything. And we ended up going to the 50 Shades of Men male review. There is a club here in Chicago. It's like on Diversey and Laramie, just about. And I think that's Laramie. I might be lying. It's somewhere over there, right? No, that's like Diversey and Central. So we ended up going to the 50 Shades of Men male review. I actually enjoy myself. Definitely need them to get some better choreography because that shit was hilarious. It was a lot of 1-2 body roll or sidearm, arms to the top, body roll, rub the chest. That was their whole choreography. And I was like, what the fuck is this? But I mean, good God, were they fine. My God. If y'all in Chicago, look it up. Oh, excuse me. Sorry, y'all. Look it up. 50 Shades of Men male review. Definitely on Groupon. Shout out to my Sarah, because that's where she got them tickets from. And then we had fun. And then we went out to eat. And forgot the name of that restaurant. But shout out to them, too. Y'all, we was out late. And I was like, my God, I'm sleepy. So shout out to my ships, my Sororas, all the beautiful women of Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority Incorporated. I will not yip. You will not get me. So again, thanks ladies to my sisters. I had a wonderful time. I just want to say a very big fuck you to the Kia dealership in Berwyn, Illinois. Here's why. Now this is not a shout out. I'm just saying fuck you. So I had an appointment. Now, originally, I had an appointment on a Saturday for 8 a.m. to go to the dealership. Now, I just don't be making no 8 a.m., you know, appointments. But I thought I was going to be filming a short film that day. I ended up wrapping early. So, thought my appointment was at 8 a.m. 3 days earlier, before my appointment, I get an email from the dealership saying, hey, don't forget about your appointment on Saturday at 11:45 a.m. I'm like, okay, I'm not gonna, you know, tell them any fucking thing. I get to sleep for a few extra hours. Saturday comes, go to the Kia dealership. You know, I get there a few minutes early, gotta sit in the fucking line because this one lady refuses to move her fucking car. Okay, whatever. Get up there, get out of my car. I'm like, I have an 11:45 appointment. He's not paying attention to me. Fuck, customer service is whack as fuck. So finally, the guy at the counter decides to pay attention. Okay, is that your car? Yes, sir, it is my car. It's right now, it's 11:57. I had an 11:45 appointment. I'm here for a tune-up and an oil change. That's what the email says. That's what the fuck y'all have been sending me. Apparently, never had my appointment in the books. Who the fuck is sending these emails? So now he's like, oh, if you're here for a tune-up, that's going to take all day. Sir, no, that's not what the fuck I planned. Because that's not what the fuck I had planned. Okay, now he's, you know, coming up with all these fucking charges. Oh, you're going to have to pay this and this and this. No, sir. I have a 100,000-mile warranty. I actually think it's 150,000 miles. You need to look that shit up. I'm not paying for anything. And I have a free gift card for an oil change. Still ended up paying $100 for some fucking filters and everything else that I need. I feel like every time I go there, they just get over on me. And it's like, why the fuck does two filters cost $100. I'm sick of this shit. So fuck you, the Kia dealership. I ended up having to stay there for 3 hours. Even though I had a fucking appointment. Turns out I didn't need a tune-up. Who the fuck? Why are y'all sending me stuff saying I need a tune-up? If that's not what I need. I'm not a fucking mechanic. I don't know. So fuck y'all. And now I'm back to my happy self. Shout out to my best friend, Dominique. You know what? I had planned on being a bum on Sunday. Sunday came, and then it was like 11 o'clock, and then Dominique sent me a text message about some fucking sweaters on sale, 40% off at Charlotte Russe, and I was like, my God, now we have to go. So we actually had a very interesting day. We went to Charlotte Russe, and we went to Route 21, got myself some good stuff. We got these really dope sweaters. Now listen, y'all, they were in the men's section, super long sweaters, but what we decided is these are going to look dope as fuck with some leggings and some really cute boots. So, and the sweaters were $5. Shout out to Route 21 because we got our lives. And then we had another adventure as we did Dasher, I think it is. You guys, you can look that up. It was a whole fucking day. And I was like, my God. And we got lost. And then we ended up in a whole different northern suburb. And I don't even know how the fuck we got there. But shout out to Dominique because I ain't complaining. It was actually a very interesting day. And that was, you know, my weekend. So I had a lot of fun. And you guys, let's move on to therapy-free. Now, this week, and just thinking about my last therapy session, here's what I learned. Here's what I've been implementing into my days. My therapist told me before I go to sleep, and I think I talked to you all about this last week. My therapist told me before you go to sleep, say 3 to 5 things that you're thankful for or you're grateful for. And, you know, I'd be going to sleep, then I forget. So I do it. If I don't remember to do it before I go to sleep, first thing when I wake up, you know, sitting up in my bed or walking around, whatever I'm doing, I'm naming 5 things that I'm grateful for, right? So therapy is this. What are you grateful for? We walk around every day. We complain so much. You know, we seem to think that nothing is going right. Everything is messed up. We have an attitude about this. We have an attitude about that. But you never say what you're grateful for. Because everything can't be bad if you still have things, if you're still living, if you're still breathing, if you still have your car, if you still have your apartment, you still have your job, you still have money. It may not be the amount of money that you would like, but you still have money. You're still able to pay your bills. You're still able to support yourself financially. You're still able to go out and spend money on drinks and foods, and you can still go shopping. You're still able to do things. So you have to just take some time and say it out loud. Release it into the universe, say it out loud, and just name 3 to 5 things that you're grateful for. And if you want to implement it in your everyday life, that's even better because you become more aware of the simple things in life, but the things that matter to you and the things that you're grateful for, you become more aware of that when you say it out loud every day. So that's what I want you guys to just kind of, if you feel like it, implement it into your days. Name 3 to 5 things that you are thankful for. I'm telling you, it's really helping me a lot. So I do it every day now. Not one day. It's only been like a week and a half so far. But you know what? I have not forgotten to do it not one day. Because now it's super important to me that I say it and that I know it. And that I know it to be true. Because I am really grateful for so many things. So you guys, that's it for Therafree. And it is the end of the show. I didn't want to keep talking so long. I feel like I'm going over. So you guys, make sure you go and follow Vibez Podcast on Facebook and Twitter. That's Vibez with a Z, V-I-B-E-Z, Vibez Podcast. And on Instagram, it's askvibez@gmail.com. No, that's the email. My God, I'm simple. On Instagram, it's just askvibez, A-S-K-V-I-B-E-Z. Make sure you're following. Shout out to all the people who have been following the Vibez Instagram page. The number of followers are shooting up. So thanks to everybody who's following. And I just learned that I have some listeners over in London. If you are listening to this episode, I truly appreciate you all. I am grateful. See, that's the thing that I'm that's a thing that I'm grateful for. You all can now go and subscribe to Vibez Podcast on Spotify now and iHeartRadio. Guess who's back? And Apple Podcasts and everywhere else you can hear a podcast. Oh, you guys, if you like, you can subscribe on Spreaker. That's S-P-R-E-A-K-E-R. So SoundCloud, everywhere. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends to... I'm sick of telling y'all, tell your fucking friends to do some stuff. You know, just do it. Ad, Nike needs to pay me. Again, you guys, if you know anybody who has been in like one of those terrible relationship situations, it could be anything. Or if you've been in one, send an email to askvibez@gmail.com. That's askvibez@gmail.com. That's only if you want to share your story. I'll definitely read it on the next episode because I am interested. I am interested. I think that's it, y'all. I think that's it. You know, we've come to the end of the show. It's about that time. Oh, so now you want to be woke when a bitch been in an alarm clock since day one. Well, beep, beep, motherfuckers. Beep, beep, motherfuckers, and I'm out this bitch.